You haven't tried virtual reality before?
No, I never.
How are you feeling?
Well, in this moment, I just took a pain pill, which I don't care to take.
We have this instinct in America to treat things with pills, and that can lead to dependency. There's got to be something else we can do.
Okay, let's see what happens here.
And what we found was that virtual reality can significantly improve somebody's quality of life.
Oh my.
Virtual reality is powerful because it's as if the VR has temporarily inoculated the brain against pain. With virtual reality, we've seen a 50% reduction in pain.
So do you feel like you're in a hospital now, or?
I definitely forgot I was in the hospital.
I'm Brennan Speigel, Director of Health Services Research for Cedars-Sinai. If I see any new biomedical innovation, whether it's a technology or otherwise, my first instinct is it's not going to work. That's the null hypothesis. That's what science is based on. As of 3 years ago, I hadn't even heard of virtual reality. Matt Stoudt and the Applied VR team came in and they told me about this technology that sort of nudges the brain.
What you're going to do right now is a virtual reality experience that we've created to demonstrate the ability of VR to hijack the brain.
And they had me stand on top of a building. And my brain was hijacked. My brain thought, I am about to die. And they said, just go ahead and jump off the building. Just leap off. And I said, no chance, I'm not gonna do that. And I said, well, you know that your feet are standing on carpet, right? And I said, my feet know that, but my brain doesn't know that. I could not disambiguate this virtual reality from real reality. And I realized at that moment that this was a technology that can overwhelm the mind, and it could be used for evil. But maybe it could be used for good also. You know, we talk about virtual reality like it's one thing, but VR, the headset, is like a syringe. What I mean by that is, what matters is not the syringe, what matters is what medicine goes through the syringe. What is the patient seeing, feeling, hearing, experiencing? That's the therapeutic arm of virtual reality.
I don't know how we do this, but it would be great to figure out if there's a way to build a sensor into the headset. It relaxes them to the point where they can start to fall asleep. Dr. Brennan Speigel has been an amazing partner for us. We're using immersive technology to help address the pain crisis in America.
Opioids are now the biggest drug epidemic in American history.
If you have a major operation or any kind of surgery, or even if you haven't had an operation, you get a pill. If you take one day of opioids, there's a 6% chance you'll be dependent on it 12 months later. That's how powerful they are in causing dependency.
Recently, I was in the hospital every month. I had extreme pain. So I'm on like 30 different medications right now. There comes a point when you're taking so many meds, it almost feels like nothing is really helping. We had to do something to change the situation. And that's actually where I met Dr. Speigel. They were doing the trial project for the virtual reality program.
Oh my gosh. The breeze is blowing through. There's the Hollywood sign. And there's my house.
In that study, we found that it runs interference in a way that affects the way the brain is experiencing the physical phenomena of illness.
Thank you so much, Cy. You have no idea.
Dr. Speigel's team is doing some incredible things. When I'm in there, I forget about my pain, I forget about what I'm going through. It allows me to go even longer without taking my pain meds.
People ask, what happens when they take the headset off? Do they then need the opioid? And what's so fascinating is the answer is no. It hasn't cured the underlying disease, but for a period of time, the brain is in a different place.
How are you feeling? I heard you had some abdominal pain. Is that right?
Yeah. The medicine wears your body out.
Yeah. See if that's comfortable on your face. Let me know what you're seeing.
I'm in the water with the dolphins. Oh, wow. My back was hurting before you guys came in here.
Does this help at all?
Yeah. This is not hurting now.
We've had now almost 2,500 people at Cedars-Sinai receive therapeutic immersive virtual reality. And it's amazing to me if I think back to jumping off that building to see just how this has exploded. And for us to be able to provide a little respite for somebody suffering from pain without having to turn to a pharmacotherapy or an opioid, that's compelling.
Back to real reality for a second.
With virtual reality, we've seen a 50% reduction in pain.
We're also looking at ways we can bring in what's called a haptic device, something that actually can vibrate and bring in the sense of touch. The more senses we can immerse, the more powerful we can make this therapy. therapeutic.
The most amazing things I realized after using the virtual reality is that I could take my mind off the pain.
The goal is not for people to be in VR forever. The goal is to train the mind with increasingly sophisticated techniques to appreciate real reality, having a different mindset upon reemerging into the world. Just like mindful meditation, there's just a new way of tweaking the mind to become sort of super better, in essence.